Hello YouTube, it is Damien, it's The Return, it's episode 31 of The Return, and today we have our first Champions League group stage game for this season against Ajax away at the Johan Cruyff Arena. I normally bring you the group stage draw, or was on stream yesterday, we were laughing, we were talking about all sorts of things, gambling away in chat in terms of the gambling casino we have going on in chat as well, and we press space by one too many times, and we skip the draw. I'm telling you now, that might be something to do in the future, because the group we got was pretty insane. Now, not being too disrespectful to Ajax, Porto and Berlin. Berlin, by the way, actually got relegated last season, the year before, and then finished fourth this year, which was interesting. We were seeded third, and this is probably as good as a group as we could have got. We got Ajax, Porto and Berlin. Ajax, Porto and ourselves are very, very, very much roughly around the same sort of wavelength in terms of how good our teams are and the quality and that. We did play Sporting last year in the semi-final. We pumped them, but I expect Porto to be that next level a bit better. And Berlin, obviously, being relegated 2 years ago, then finishing fourth, and I don't know how they've started. They're seventh in the Bundesliga at the moment. I would imagine they're going to be plucky, but I would think against all three teams at home, we should be winning, and then away from home, we should at least be taking enough points that we should be getting out of this group, and we should progress. This is a very good draw for us, and I'm very happy. We do have Ajax, though, here today, and we have to get into what's been going on in terms of the fixtures and everything like that. So since we last met, which was Liverpool, we lost 4-3 in a thriller to PSG. We played 4-2-4. We went out, and we were 3-1 down, and then changed the system in the 4-2-4 to being quite direct, quite long ball, two goals, and then Rodri scored in the 90th minute from a set piece where they lipped the back stick, and yeah, up until 3-1, up until the 75th minute until we changed it, we dominated. From the 75th minute to the 90th, we had about 6-7 clear-cut chances. My main worry is Fabio Silva's not scoring them, but it is what it is. We then played Nantes at home. We played the 4-2-4 again, and then Fabio Silva scored goals in this game, which was great. Holzak missed a penalty, which wasn't, obviously, because Adam had a worldy of a game till then. He was looking good. He was on a 7-odd, and he had the penalty. He's got 15 penalties, unfortunate. But we pumped Nantes in the 4-2-4. Not keeping the ball, but our 4-2-4 was all about counter-press, win the ball, off you go. So that was like that. And then we played Remmers away from home. We played 4-2-3-1 because this is a bit more of a tighter game. And against Renners, it did work out. Look, they came back into it. We had chances to go 4-1 up. We didn't. And then they made it squeaky bum time. And before not too long, we also have to say, I think Mori had a worldy of a game in one of these games. I can't remember which one it is. Yeah, this one here. Against Nantes started to come back into it after 5-2, and he made some saves, Mori, it has to be said. Because in this Angers game, even though we kept the clean sheet, I still feel like Mori made some decent saves here to keep his clean sheet. I think both chances that were on target, they should have scored by memory. In the end, though, there's a new signing, which we'll talk about as well. We fully rotated playing 4-2-3-1, apart from Tosin, who's still unhappy with us because we rejected a big bid from Spurs and Liverpool on deadline day for him, about 40 million from both. He doesn't want to go because he wanted to join Spurs. He doesn't want to join Liverpool, however, which is very interesting. Maybe because he's a Man City supporter. Maybe that's what it is. And while we're on the same thing, Stefan has got interest from both of those teams too. And I would not be expecting anything less than 80 million for Stefan as well. But yeah, in terms of the new signing, mainly because we got a big offer for Dino on deadline day, for 5.5. It was on big wage. I didn't want to keep him. The whole idea was to bring him in on a free so he could provide backup and then, you know, really lay out his determination on Killian and then Solomon. Very smart business. And then on deadline day, Noel Gavlins was transferred for 500k. Just with the stats and how well rounded he is, he might turn into another Kevlin. But with how well rounded he is in the stats and that he's French, 500k, I didn't think we could go wrong. He started well in the league. He had a pretty good appearance first game up in the 4-0 win. And you will expect to see a bit more of him. I just like the fact that fullback on attack, he can do it. Wingback on attack in the 4-4 and the 4-4-2, he can do it. And I just think because he's so well-rounded, if he does grow and hit some form, he will definitely be free start, and that's really it. So we currently sit in third. You know, we've obviously lost one game to PSG. PSG have also drawn and lost the game already, and Lyon have played five teams that they should be beating, apart from maybe Nice. But Nice have really fallen off the bottle last season and this season. So yeah, interesting. Anyway, we are away at Ajax. Obviously, Berlin starting their campaign at home. We are going to get to the game. I already thought we were there, but apparently not. We've got to talk about the team as well. This is the first time, due to injuries and everything, that Mubia and Stefan will be here. Mubia actually won Player of the Month just gone. As you can see, two goals, three assists. No play of the matches, even though he's averaging an 8 in the league, which is interesting. But yeah, Thiago Sarr hasn't been playing because of the form of Mori. I do want Mori to grow because I do think he will become first choice, especially with Valenka here now. And if Valenka grows, he's going to be outstanding. But yeah, Thiago Sarr, Killian, Tosin, Koing, and Sober will be in Stefan, Adam Holzak, Mulateri, Hadzic, and Silva in the 4-2-3-1 away from home. I definitely think 4-2-4 will definitely be an option for us in the future as well. But we'll see how we go. Hopefully, we'll do okay. So, happy girlfriend, happy life. She's just texting me, which is always nice when it happens during a thing. I think she's getting her hair done at the moment, which is not bad. And we're going to ask the assistant, and we're going to go and press, and we're going to continue on. And I can't deny it makes things a bit easier. Look, Sar will get through the 4 minutes. And yeah, obviously playing Mori means that Sar's not bad. Sorry about the dead air, boys and girls and ladies and gentlemen watching. Just concentrating on what the girlfriend was saying. I'll get back to her after this game's finished. Anyway, 5 minutes in, 0-0. I would take, and by the way, it probably might be on. We've moved the speed back. Thiago Sar's made a save. Well, let's just rewind here just quickly because I feel like the speed was going to be up. Because when I play offline by myself, I generally speed it up. That is hit the bar and Sar. That's fine. Anyway, back to live. Block is put in there by probably Hadzic. And 6 minutes in, we get away with it against Ajax. I expect Ajax at home to be quite good. You know, they've got Higuain up top. You know, they've got Quincy Promise there as well, who's very experienced. Van de Beek and Ryan are still here as well. Ryan's obviously unbelievable. And yeah, and here he's on the ball out the Jordi Alba. They've got quite the side, haven't they? Ajax, geez. Van de Beek again, Quincy Promise back into Van de Beek. And away we go. Big ball out to Tadic. They moved it around so well. Tadic in the end, Sars with a defensive mistake and goal. And it is in what it is. But yeah, hopefully, it's not a sign of things to come here in this group stage game, that is for sure. Anyway, ball in a promise. Good ball in a Tadic. Really, Thiago Sarr should do a lot better, shouldn't he, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen? But yeah, highlight from kickoff. Look, we know if we get going, we're okay. A point would be huge against Ajax, I do think as well. I think away from home, points is massive. Because I think at home we'll beat most sides. Anyway, Adam down the touchline. Brett brought down by Jordi Alba. And referee wants to go consult VAR. It's a clear-cut penalty, so we're just going to speed this up here a little bit. And Jordi Alba. How much did he move for? We might have to look at that here with this Ajax side. Penalty is given. We have got Holzak out there. He has missed one already for us. But 15 penalties. Good composure. To step up. And into the side netting we go. The penalty he missed, he hit the post. You know, He goes for the corners. I like it. And it's not like he's hit it up the middle or anything when he missed his pen. And he hasn't hit up the middle there. And he scores. It's a great penalty that. Keeper's got no chance. Inside of post and in. And we move back into top spot in terms of the group. But it's way too early to think about it. But yeah, Jordi Alba here. It still looks decent, you know, for Ajax at 33. Porto 1-0 up. I expect Hervé to lose a lot of games. Anyway, chipped long towards Promise. And a ball out to Tadic. I tell you what, I'm tempted to move into 4-2-4. Mainly because I think Ajax are going to keep the ball so well, and we can. Higuain's going to head just wide, and we can press him. So maybe something we're going to do at half time. Maybe to move into 4-2-4 because we're not keeping the ball too great, which is what we like to do in this 4-2-3-1. But we are creating chances, and I do believe in the 4-2-4. In games where we don't keep the ball the best, we can still go out and be very aggressive in the 4-2-4. That's a great ball out to Sobel, and with a chance here to whip Sobel. In the end, he lays it to Stefan, too far out to do anything. Mobia looks for Adam, heads down, Killian. Good move from us, though. That's what we do in the 4-2-3-1. We move the ball around exceptionally well. I knew as soon as it came out my mouth and Stefan turned around and stopped that we were going to lose the ball. And Marin's run past like three people. He's gone for goal. It's wide. And yeah, I'm trying to think. With the players that we got out there, how would I go with this? I actually think we'll be changing it definitely at halftime. I'm not happy how this game is kind of petering out at the moment. Just tactically don't think it's that great. Anyway, Marin there with the ball over to Tadic. And that's a tackle in a half by Killian, but it falls back to Tadic, though. And it's a block that falls back to Jordi Alba. So this is probably going to be a goal for Ajax, because I find a lot this year on FM that if the ball keeps falling back to the opposition, they score. Tadic now gets tackled, and Adam now with the ball over the top looking for Fabio. Vertonghen and his centre-back have run into each other. Fabio Silva's not going to miss that. It's a defensive mistake by both centre-backs. It's a defensive mistake by Vertonghen and Daley Blind. And Fabio has scored a 1-on-1. That's the one thing we were complaining on stream yesterday, is he doesn't score 1-on-1s at the moment. Even though we've taught him to run around the goalkeeper, he hasn't. in the end, Blin's kind of just backtracking Venom and they've run into each other. And Fabio's like, okay, then I'll get the ball and just slot it. Keeper really should do better, which is a guy I've never heard of. And yeah, there we go. We're 2-1 up. And that gives me food for thought. Now I'm just like, I don't know what I do. I don't know if we do go 4-2-4 now. We're not keeping the ball well. We're definitely on the break are going to be a lot better. But our 4-2-4 is not as defensive. I might stay now that we've pinched the goal. I might stay with it. Anyway, 50-odd minutes played. Mulateri's not having his best of game out there. I'll maybe go 4-2-4 and get Mulateri off. But if we scored right now, there's no point doing it. Adam! There we go. It's 3-1. We might not be having the best of this game, but we are still creating. In the end, Adam has scored his fourth of the season, his second of the game. And look, it's a great volley. And that's why the Lamb, I will give credit to Lamb. The Lamb would score an opportunity like this. But the Lamb in the one-on-one situations that Adam has scored in preseason, did score on the opening day, the Lamb would normally miss. Very tight, but we can't see what Adam is. And yeah, not bad from us. And now Tosin, if you can maybe keep the ball here with Killian, we'll be okay. In the Stefan and Adam now. And with Killian on a booking, I don't want to go down to 10 men as well. I might get him off anyway. Morbia, Adam, looking to beat his man. Killian now can whip one. He does. Doesn't find Fabio Silva. Finds to Morbia, and he's put it wide. I've seen him score from distance already this year. And yeah, well, Killian and Tosin both not having their best games and both on bookings. I am going to get Killian off early here, give Nolan the time. Like, Nolan's actually not too far off Killian's level. 2.5 star for now is a League One player. 3 star for us is now a good League One player, because comparing to Morbia and that, who are 4.5 stars, and Tosin, who are leading players, 4.5 stars and more, and Stefan and that. You're getting rated against that. So two and a half stars the mark, which is good. So these guys on 2 stars have a lot of room to grow. Anyway, we're going to get Tosin off as well. Don't want the red card. I believe we're controlling this game very well. And with that in mind, I might get Mulateri off because he's had a shocker, and get Pietro Pellegrini in the hole. Pietro's been playing quite well. He's actually got 4 goals this year already himself. He's been playing quite well in the hole. If they score right now, Daly hits the bar, and in the end, Thiago Silva does the job. We would have been squeaky bum time after making 3 changes, but I think we're still going to be okay. The 4-2-3-1 has worked, which is good. Maybe not in the way we expected it. You know, we expected to dominate the ball, whatever. Maybe against Ajax, a bit naive. But the 4-2-4 definitely, I think on paper, would have worked better. What a ball from Morbia. In the end, he slotted it past the keeper, but Ventimiglia on the line will clear. And yeah, what a ball from Morbia. He is that good. I'm just going to praise the boys here with not long left, just to make sure they don't concede. And even though we haven't kept the ball, we've had 20 shots this game. And that's the thing. Herbert's trying to make a comeback here. Anyway, Adam Holzak is in. Fabio there on the cutback, finds him. That's a save and a half. And that's the thing. Fabio's missing chances like that of late, and I don't like it. He should bury that. Sobel's ball in, back stick. Adam's headed over. He should have had a hat-trick there. But, look, good win from us. 3-1 up. And the game's going to peter out here. That's a great start for us. Away points are going to be massive. Ajax did look plucky. They're definitely going to be there or thereabouts. I think the big one for us is Porto. Porto, especially after beating Hertha Berlin. That's a foul there by Gavilans, but that's fine, or Galvins. But as long as we don't concede, I don't really mind. Velleman, Van Ginkel, don't let him turn. I don't want to concede right now. And yeah, like, I think if we get through Porto, if we can get through a point away from Porto and then at home against Porto, we'll be okay. I think we'll get through this group not too bad. No disrespect to Herve, but on paper, I just don't think they're as good as the other couple of teams and ourselves in this group. We actually got Herve coming up next. I might not show you that game on YouTube, and I think what we're going to do is we're going to be back for the Porto home and away game, because I think it's Berlin, and then we got Porto and Porto. Yes, we do. So I think what we'll do, YouTube, is don't see the Hertha Berlin game. We'll come back for the Porto and Porto game. And I tell you what, if we beat Berlin, we beat Porto, we're through the group, and then I'll come back at the end of that episode, withdraw, whatever like that. But and hopefully that's how it goes, but we'll wait and we'll see. But yeah, very good performance from us. We sit third in the group. We start our Champions League campaign with a win, and I do believe with the group that we got, which is on paper relatively easy, that we will be A-OK, and we can get through this group, and for the first time, we'll be into the knockout stages of the Champions League. From Damo and everybody here, go give the video a like, go subscribe, and we usually stream, so links down below. Go get us on stream, and come and check us out, and I'll catch you guys next time. Thank you, and goodbye.